Every story has a hero who is celebrated for his courage and spirit. I too have a story, and my hero is a motorcycle. It's only when you are alone at midnight in your room, we realize that we really miss something in our life. Life has a meaning. And the best way to find it out is by traveling beyond our comfort zone. When half of the world is asleep, I answer to the call of mountains. Ahead of me is the brown road that opened the doors of adventure into the wilderness and to the unknown. Feeling that I have that strong determination and willpower to take on most adventurous journey, like traveling from western borders of Rajasthan to northeastern borders of Ladakh. Not until 200 kilometers into my journey, I realized that I was wrong.
Kya age aapka?
Huh?
Age kya? Umar kya aapka?
Umar hoga 60 lagbhag.
60. Is umar mein paidal ja raha hu. Kahan se aa rahe ho?
चार बीघा राजसमंद जिला।
कितना दूर है यहाँ से?
यहाँ से होगा ना 100 किलोमीटर ऊपर होगा।
बहुत पाली से? बहुत पाली से?
नहीं नहीं अटाव हो 150 किलोमीटर लगभग।
अकेले जा रहे हो?
नहीं हम सब साथ में।
I saw people walking hundreds of kilometers under the hot sun in 40 degrees on a national highway. Just to have a glimpse of their deity. This is my India. They can simply get into a bus or car, reach Bikaner, and can worship their deity. But they didn't do that. Indeed, they took the hardest path. I wonder who has more determination and willpower. In our house, motorcycle is the only way of transport we had for us. From my childhood, I am always fascinated by that thumping sound, metallic body and protruding engines. At the age of 12, I had my first biking experience. From then, there is no looking back.
भाग्यो सुस्त हरी एकांत दुनियामा फेरि मलाई उडाइ
Another thing I strongly felt was that it is impossible to reach Leh Ladakh on a bike having cc less than 250. To my surprise, I met two guys who were riding all the way from Kolkata on a 100cc Hero Honda bike. It's not an ordinary thing. I mean, what can I say? Hats off to them. It was a bit challenging for me to cover 5000 kilometers spanning 9 different states in 20 days. I mean, my days are limited. I have to fall back to my final destination on 20th day. Anything can go wrong, literally anything, and I don't have a plan B. And I'm riding solo. It's a bad idea, but at the same time, it's thrilling. One thing I thought unique about me was that I am immune to acute mountain sickness. I have traveled from 6000 feet to 18000 feet in just 2 days without any acclimatization. But I was proved wrong again. This time by a gentleman named Vishwesh, who is in his 50s exploring all over India on his bike.
Yes, it's a beautiful morning. What to say about, I'm so attached to these mountains. I can't express what it is to me. Now heading towards Mount Abu, I had a plan to halt at Chandigarh, but we'll see how the day is going and then plan accordingly. Oh wow, even the local people asking me, don't you feel cold? See, this is my getup, only on shorts, and everything is in mind, man, everything is in mind. Okay.
After meeting these people, I became more humble and simple. Humility is the greatest lesson that I learned from this journey. We all live in our own well and develop our own views. Until we come out from that bubble, we never know the reality. Motorcycling gives us the chance to come out of that and experience everything that this world has to offer from the seat of our bike. It's not a smooth ride for me. My clutch plate got damaged while I was on way to Manali. My suspension system got damaged while going to Tso Moriri. I had flat tire near Pune. And luckily every time I received the help, thanks to all of them. This journey is not less than a fulfilled life for me. It's like a spiritual experience. Some days I have slept under furnished rooms, some days under tents, and some other days under roadside dump. Some days I had good food, some days it's just water and biscuits. Some days I was under hot sun, some days under snowfall, and some other days under rainfall. Some moments I contemplated, and at some moments I am joyful. I have seen beautiful sunrises and star-lit skies. From green mountains to naked mountains, I witnessed the marvelous creations of God. From small streams to lakes, I have enjoyed the sound of every drop. Riding on national highways to hilly roads and to the places where there are no roads, I have felt the gentle touch of nature. On the way, I met my old friends, made new friends, met families that showered immense love and support. Behind the scenes of my journey, there were people who guided me constantly, my parents who continuously prayed for me, and finally, the Almighty, who appeared in some or other form whenever I ran into a problem. I am grateful to all of them. What an impeccable journey. At the end, I am not asking everyone to pick up your motorcycle and go to mountains. It's just that when you are alone, sit back and just think what you really miss in life. You'll find your calling. Julie.